So it is April, and the legendary Taurus Dragon has been released as the new dragon of the month. The Taurus Dragon is a legendary earth and fire dragon with a base attack of 73 and health of 248 with all elements unlocked. It might not be the best legendary to use on most teams, but you need to breed him to complete the Zodiac collection. So let's take a look at how to breed him. Today I've chosen the three best combinations that I believe will be the best for most players, but do be aware that there are hundreds of different combinations that you could use. So the number one best combination I would suggest for you to use to breed the Taurus Dragon would be the Orange plus Metal Dragons. Of course, you can replace the Orange Dragon with dragons that have the same elements, such as the Armadillo, Maple Leaf, Werewolf, Pumpkin Dragons, etc. So the reason I say this is the best combination instead of some others is because the Orange Dragon is really easy to get a hold of for most players, and plus this combination only has 5 other possible outcomes, the longest one being a 10-hour breed base. If you have a set schedule every day, then this combination works really well since all breeds are between 6 and 10 hours. So you can breed in the morning, go to school or work, come back, and then breed again. If you need to know how to breed the Orange Dragon, then I have made a breeding guide on it before, so the link will be in the description. But overall, this combination is very good, and I highly recommend that you use it. So the second best combination I would suggest is the Bell plus Fire Dragons. So again, you can replace the Bell Dragon with the Gentleman, Mountain, and Golem Dragons, and this combo will work just as well. So this combination also only has 5 other possible outcomes, and a couple of them have breeding times of less than 2 hours. The only downside to this combo is the fact that the dragons are all limited time, and the longest breeding time is 16 hours for the Orange Dragon. If you're someone that can log in at random intervals when your dragons have finished breeding, then this would be the better combo over combo 1. If you don't have many dragon collector points, you also won't have the runestone as a possible outcome. So both combo 1 and combo 2 can be better than one another depending on your circumstance, so keep that in mind. However, if you're someone that doesn't even have any epics, then fear not. The third best combination I would suggest to you to use would be the War plus Tree Dragons. Now this combination has the downside of having 9 other possible outcomes, meaning you're a lot less likely to breed the Taurus Dragon with this combo compared to the first two. However, this combination gives you the chance to breed the Orange Dragon. This means that you can use this combination, and if you manage to breed the Orange Dragon, then you can start using the other combo instead. But this combo is very, very good for newer players. And in case you were wondering, the breeding time for the Taurus Dragon is 2 days normally, reduced to 1 day and 14 hours with VIP active. So if you see a really long breeding time, you know you've bred him successfully. Now if you're wondering what level your breeding dragons like your Orange Dragon should be, then I highly recommend leveling them up to level 15 minimum, if you can. I tend to level up my dragons to level 25 when breeding legendaries because I can easily afford the food to do so, but it is not a necessity. Just remember that the higher your breeding dragon levels are, the higher your chances are of breeding legendary and epic dragons. But the best tip I can give you when trying to breed legendary dragons is to rebreed as many times as possible. Your chances of breeding the Taurus Dragon are quite low, sitting between 1 to 4% depending on the combination you're using. So it will likely take you many attempts to get the legendary dragon. Just don't lose hope and keep rebreeding as often as you possibly can to give yourself the best chance of getting the dragon of the month. And do remember that there are so many other combinations out there. These were just the 3 that I cut it down to that would be easiest for most people to use. Let me know if you got lucky and managed to breed him yourself. Oh, and do remember that other DML players also hang around in our Discord server quite a lot. So if you want to chat with any of them, then feel free to join the server for free. But anyway, so that should be everything you need to know about breeding the Taurus Dragon this month. Good luck, and I'll have more DML videos out very soon.